Good morning, welcome to a new video, this time about a trading strategy from my book which you see here in the background. A strategy to find strong stocks that no one is talking about. This is what I will present you now. The strategy is from my book Trading Systems, which you see here. All codes in this book you can find free on my website, and to this book and to the codes I also have a 6-hour MA Broker video course for which you get a special discount which you find below the video. So let's dive directly into the strategy I want to show you. It's a Bollinger strategy, and you see here the strategy logic on an example of advanced micro devices. This is a daily chart over several years, and the important point is that usually strong breakouts occur after longer sideways phases. So in this case the stock made a 3-year sideways phase, and people get desperate. They don't see the stock move, they see it moving sideways, and even worse, they see it moving downwards. And so many people get more and more desperate and are surprised by a breakout. And when this breakout occurs, it's where our Bollinger strategy buys. And this breakout usually comes together with an increased volatility, which you see here below. And this increased volatility makes the Bollinger bands wider. So it is a strong signal if a stock moves above these Bollinger bands, because they are getting wider when the volatility increases. And in the strategy example from my book, which I present you here, we calculate the Bollinger bands with an 180-day simple moving average, and we put a upper Bollinger band 3.5 standard deviations on top, and the lower band here, it is symmetrical, but in my strategy the lower Bollinger band moves closer. The bottom Bollinger band here has just 0.5 standard deviations, and the top Bollinger band has 3.5 standard deviations. And here you see how the signal generation for a stock works. So when the stock moves out of this Bollinger band, here was the breakout above the upper Bollinger band, then you buy the very next day on an open, you enter the market. And let me see, show you how this works on a longer time scale. Here for example on the Nvidia stock, and the trade was entered the first time here in 2014, when the stock was moving over the upper Bollinger band, but it was stopped out here because the stock moved below the lower Bollinger band. But again you got the next signal here about 1 year later, and this trade was kept until the end of 2018, when the stock was stopped out again. And you see here that the stop was really useful, and that this lower Bollinger band made a good job in letting your profits run. But how to use this in practice? There are some further things to take care of. The first thing is, many stocks don't have breakouts often. For example, Coca-Cola, which is a stock for example which value investors like Warren Buffett have held for many years in their portfolios because of their value. But here we want to look for breakouts, and it happens very seldom that Coca-Cola breaks out so strong that it has so much momentum to break above a Bollinger band, which is 3.5 standard deviations away. So we have for example here 6 years without any Bollinger signal, and you see on this chart of maybe 70 years, let's say, you have maybe only 20 signals. So it needs years to wait until you get a signal on a single stock. And the way out of this is that you can scan a huge universe of stocks instead on a daily basis. And like this, you more often get signals. So you don't focus on just one stock. Instead, you take a huge portfolio of stocks and let the market decide, or let the stocks themselves decide, which you buy then. And we can backtest this, but for backtesting such portfolios, it's very important that you have good data. Accurate data really matters. And for this, I'm using the data of NorgateData.com. In my opinion, the best data supplier for retail traders. And you see here, for example, if you work on the wrong data, if you just backtest on the 500 stocks of the S&P 500, which are at the moment in the index, you get this equity curve. So this is the sum of all trading signals, which is too optimistic. And the realistic equity curve is shown below. And how to do such backtests, I will show you now in AmiBroker directly. This Bollinger Band strategy you can find on my website. So you just go to my website, urbanstocks.com, select this English flag here, and then you are in the English area of my website. There is also a German area, but at the moment we need the English area. And here in the English area, you go to the folder codes. First, you see the beginning of month strategy. For this, I have produced another video recently. But at the moment, we need the Bollinger Band strategy. So you mark all this code here. And go all the way down until this ends here. Copy it with your keyboard and then go to AmiBroker and go to the AmiBroker formula editor. Here you just paste in the whole code. First you save it on a place. I have here the folder April 2021. Give it a name, for example, Bollinger New. And then we verify the syntax to make sure that there is no error in the code, and then send it to the analysis window. And now we have the code here in our analysis window. At the moment, this code is set for the Russell 1000, which you can see here in the code. The code is set for the S&P 500, which you see here. And so we first test it on S&P 500 and make sure you have here the correct backtester setting. So you put in here SPX, pad and align all data to this reference symbol S&P 500 index. This makes sure that your test universe is synchronized, that all the stocks are synchron with the S&P 500 index. And also here, this is nice. Here you include the buy and hold statistics of the S&P 500 index in the backtest report. So most important is to set here this pad and align all data to reference symbol. Otherwise you cannot get backtest results. This is really important. For commissions, we set 0.1% per trade, which is reasonable in liquid stocks of the S&P 500. For trades, we trade next bar on open. So as you have seen before, we wait until the stock moves above the upper Bollinger Band, and then the next day on the open, you enter the trade. Stops, we have all disabled. And then the most important, we define the filter on which stocks this strategy is applied. And here you see all the possible universes of Norgate data. We now choose the S&P 500, current and past. And you see these are 1,817 symbols which have been trading in the S&P 500 since 1995. And if you don't have such data, you would test on S&P 500, just the 500 stocks which are currently trading in the S&P 500. Please note some are double, for example, Google, and Google has two symbols. But if you would test only on these stocks, your backtest would never be accurate. So Norgate data has here many stock universes with current and past stocks. So we select here S&P 500, current and past. Here is it. And press OK. Now we have set up all the backtest settings and we just press backtest. And you see how fast Emil Broker is. So it tests within some seconds all the stocks which have been in the S&P 500 from 1995 until 2021 for Bollinger signals. And if you go all the way down, you see these 20 stocks which are in the moment in the portfolio. And these are all the stocks from the S&P 500 which are in the index now. But if you go further back, you see more and more stocks with such a date here. This is the date where they have been removed from the S&P 500 index, because S&P 500 index, it's a momentum index. There are always only these stocks which have a huge market capitalization, which are growing. So every year, new stocks are replaced, old bad stocks are replaced by better one. So, and you see the further you go back, the more and more stocks you have which are no longer in the index. So if you make our backtest now, in the year 1995, we buy all these stocks, which for example in 1997 had to leave the index, or in the year 2010. And the further we come to the present, the more and more stocks we have which are at the moment in the index. And this is a good news for people who don't use Norgate data, but any other data supplier. This means that the last few years, so in the year 2020, 2021, and 2019, usually your normal stock universe of the only S&P 500 stocks is accurate, but the more you go back, the more you have to take care about survivorship bias to be sure that you have the stocks in your strategy which are really at that point of time in your test universe when you execute your strategy. Okay, so let's just have a look at the backtest report. Press here and you can see the result of this strategy. And what we see here, we get an average annual return of 12% compared to the buy and hold index of 8.7%. But please note, we only 75% in the market, because the strategy also includes an index filter. So you don't enter new position when the complete market is below a 200 or 300 day moving average. So the risk-adjusted return is even higher. It's about 16%. And if you look at the drawdowns, we see here that the Bollinger strategy has 25% drawdown compared to the S&P 500 index, which has 56% drawdown. So this is quite nice. Let's have a look at the charts. And in the chart, you see here the equity curve. I use here logarithmic presentation of the equity curve. I share the code how to set up a logarithmic equity curve for free below the video, because this equity curve is nicer than what you usually get. As an MEBroker user, you get usually this equity curve, but if you have trading strategies with huge gains and all these gains are reinvested, this leads usually to an exponential growth, and you cannot distinguish if this phase is better or this phase is better, whereas in the logarithmic equity curve, you can really compare different phases with each other. So you see here that the recent 2 years have been strong, and here the drawdowns have not been high, especially during this Corona crisis of last year. And in general, the last year has not been good with only 3.5%, but this year you would already have gained 16%. Now I quickly want to show you how to generate this logarithmic equity curve. You just take the code which you find below this video and paste it into the correct folder, and the correct folder is I quickly show you program files, MEBroker, formulas, and then report charts. And so this code from below the video, you must give it a name and save it here into the report chart. And yes, it must be put here, and then it appears right here in the report chart when you press the backtest report button, and then you have it here. Okay, let's just do some more investigations. For example, we can backtest also another universe. Let's take the Russell 1000, which contains 1000 stocks. So I save this here. And we have to change here the settings. So now we have to pad and align with the Russell 1000 index. And we also compare with the Russell 1000. And we also have to set here the correct universe of Russell 1000 current and past. You see here you have Nasdaq 100 current and past, Russell 1000, Russell 2000, 3000, microcap, Australian market, all ordinaries, and also something like S&P 500 dividend aristocrats and Nasdaq 100 next generation. So there are some really interesting universes for you to backtest in Norgate. So let's choose Russell 1000 current and past. Okay, and press backtest and look at this tremendous speed of MEBroker. This is really nice. And let's have a look. You see again, in 1995, we have many stocks which are no longer in the index today. But let's see which stocks are in the index now. And you see, for example, MO, this is Altria, it's a tobacco stock, and Oracle. I will look now at the signals, and this works like this. You just right press and then show arrows for actual trades. But important is, let's first make a new default chart and make a new blank chart, and now go here in the section charts to where you saved your strategy, which is Bollinger New, and just drag and drop it, and then you see already the Bollinger bands like I presented here in the video. Put this on the left, this we don't need anymore. And now you can go here, right click, show arrows for actual trades, and then you also have to set here parameters, trading arrows, yes, and we want to have a date axis, yes. So you see we have a date axis, and then press here, show arrows for actual trades, and you see here the buy arrow, we have a closer look. So we have here the Bollinger Bands, and just recently this tobacco stock. You see here the close is above the Bollinger Band here. You see the value, the close was 49.84 and the upper Bollinger Band was 49.63. So the trade is entered the next day on the open, it is 49.21, which you can see here. And like this, it works. It just okay. And same thing here, for example, Oracle. You see, this happens sometimes. You have a breakout here, but the market corrects before it gains new strength. Let's have a quick look about the fundamentals of these two stocks. For this, I'm using another software, Fast Graphs. This you can rent for 20. excuse me. For $20 per month. And here you see Apple, and you see how strong this stock is. The black is the price, but this is compared here in the software with the fundamentals, and the orange line is the profit earning price earnings growth. Historically it has been here, and this has been a healthy environment for the stock, and the blue one is the PE ratio. And now the last 2 years, the markets have completely changed because of Corona. It seems reasonable that such stocks which really are value, like Apple, which are highly profitable, they have grown dramatically. But from a fundamental point of view, we can also look critically at it. For example, if you look at the forecasting here, the growth 2022 is only 6% and 2023 is only 8%. So the high growth which you have in this stock in this year may not last the next years, and this could be a critical, I mean, it's Apple, it's really, we are talking about an excellent stock here, but everybody is talking about this. And the Bollinger Band strategy finds us stocks where not so many people are talking about, and let's have a look at them. For example, MO, which is Altria Group. And you will see here that this is trading well below its historical PE ratio and growth ratio, and seems to have a lot of potential here. And let's have a quickly look at Oracle. Which is more tech stock. And you see here it has a nice momentum since many, many years. And it is growing all the time. So it's not higher valued now than it has been, for example, in 2010. And this is a quite nice difference compared, for example, with Apple, or let's have a look at Microsoft, which is quite similar to Apple. Please note, this is not a trading recommendation. Please look at the end, at the disclaimer. All these charts are just shown here for educational purposes as examples of this strategy. So you see here again Microsoft, quite high valued, but of course you would have made lots of money with it the last 2-3 years. Okay, let's go back to our Emmy broker. I want to show you one more thing. So for example, 20 stocks is quite a lot for a retail trader to hold in your portfolio. So let's set this to 5 stocks only. By the way, you can take this code and optimize all these parameters. I don't want to do this here. I've just taken the settings for my book, which I have published 2 years ago. So all these results are now out of sample. So we set this here to 5, save it, and now we still have the same index and still the Russell 1000. So we need not to change anything here. We just press backtest, and then we get only 5 stocks in our portfolio. This is maybe easier to handle for a retail trader, but take care about your money management. I will tell you later. So again, you have Oracle here on your long signal. Just have a look again at it. It was here. We have looked about its strong fundamentals. And you see here, you already had some false signals here. This also happens. Here was a breakout. Here you were stopped out with a small gain. Here it has been a small loss. But you see how this stock has been growing over time. By the way, here in the year 2000, you had here also a long signal. But let's have a look at some other stocks. For example, Moderna, which has been bought in February 2020. And let's first check the signal if it's accurate. You see here on the 27th of February, you had a breakout already here on the 26th. $29 was above the Bollinger Band, which was at 27, and the next day was quite huge, so you would have entered here on the open. It was not the best entry here at $35, and the market came down to here, so you would have in the beginning lost here 40%. This is important to know when you look at this gain afterwards. So the strategy would have hold here from these $35 until 149 at the moment, but see what in between could have happened to your money. Here you have a drawdown of 50%, for example, and this is why it's really important to have a money management, which I want to show you here. Now, first let's just see some other signals. PayPal was similar, you would have entered here and still long. And Twilio, for example, would have entered here and still long. And here it was not stopped out, the stop is the red line here on an end-of-day basis. So when the market moves below it, you exit the next day on the open. Let's go back to the presentation, because I want to show you quickly something about the money management. What does it mean if you have, for example, a very small portfolio of $10,000 and you invest $2,000 in each stock and a stop loss of 30%, which this Bollinger Band strategy typically has, or you have seen in the beginning with Moderna, it may have been 50%. This is then, for example, if you have 30%, this is $600 per position. And if you have 5 positions, this is then 6% of your portfolio. If you have 10 positions, it would only be 3%. And like this, if one signal doesn't work, you have still enough money to invest further in this strategy to continue it. And this is very important not to give up your strategy, because false signals will always happen. Not every signal will be a winner in this strategy, like in every other strategy. Okay. If you are interested in this strategy or have any questions, of course you can use the EmiBook, of course, but I'm planning to insert this in my Signal service, which I want to start this year. If you're interested, just send me an email, or if you have any questions about this strategy, at info@urbanstocks.com. And as I said, you find everything in the on the website if you're an EmiBroker user. With the EmiBroker course, I explain you every detail in 6 hours video material how to use EmiBroker on this, especially on my example codes like Bollinger beginning of the month system and some others. And so you have some possibilities to use this strategy. I will finish this with a disclaimer. Everything in this video was for educational use only. Backtests cannot look into the future. Trade at your own risk. Please read this. It's very important that I don't make any trading recommendations here, and it's on your own risk. If you like this video, please hit the like button. This helps the Google algorithm to find my videos. If you want to watch further videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.